George Schroeder from USA Today joining us now. George, you know, you can really kind of put your finger on the pulse of what's going on here in Arkansas, given the fact that you worked at the Democrat Gazette. Just your take on Jeff Long out at Arkansas as athletic director.
Well, I mean, it's mildly surprising, I guess. Obviously, the rumors have been flying for the last few weeks. And look, here's the deal. It stems, obviously, from discontent over the direction of the football program. You can say all the things that an athletic director might have done on the positive side of the balance sheet. You can talk about the ways he might have rubbed people wrong on the other side. It all comes down to the direction of the football program and how people feel about that. That's the way it is in big-time college football. That's certainly the way it is in the SEC. It's certainly the way it is in the SEC West.
Yeah, and the university, by the way, will honor the provisions of Long's contract, which currently run through June 30th, 2022. But again, it's the fact that he lost that key support within the past year. I mean, from the outside looking in, given the job that you do every day, what were some of the things you were hearing?
Well, just that, frankly. I mean, you've got you've got key people on the board of trustees. You've got key boosters, and sometimes those are the same people, not all the time, who I don't know if lost confidence is the right word, but you get crosswise with those guys, and it ends up not being a good deal. And look, I do think that obviously the future of Bret Bielema was a piece of this. I don't think that there was going to be a much different outcome had Jeff Long stayed around. I think eventually, and by eventually I mean over the next few weeks, probably a decision would have been made. I mean, it certainly appears the die's been cast there. But I do think potentially his support for Bret Bielema probably played a factor in this.
I want to ask you specifically about the football program at this point, two games left in the regular season, because you know, people have been talking, and the people who want to joke about the fact that Arkansas has had such a rough year are talking about the fact that they're just trying to restore this program to mediocrity. You know, you go all the way back to 2014 when Arkansas finished 7-6 and had one of the top 10 defenses in the nation. So are you surprised? How surprised are you, I guess, is my question, that they've fallen off so quickly?
Yeah, I'm surprised. Listen, let me start with this. Bret Bielema is a good football coach. It's just not working for whatever reason now. And it certainly appears they've missed in some recruiting battles. The thing that's probably the most surprising to me is that their offensive line hasn't been very good. That's obviously the thing that Bret Bielema would hang his hat on. It is a surprise. But sometimes just I don't even know that it's about the fit. Sometimes it's just you miss on a kid or two or five over a two- or three-year period, and a couple of things go a different direction in a game over a two- or three-year period, and a narrative turns, and there's a pivot point somewhere, and there's no coming back from it. And I think that's where we are at Arkansas.
And I'll end with this. You know, as much as you've had the opportunity to watch SEC football, when you look at Arkansas' style, you know, Bret Bielema is known for that punishing style, you know, kind of beat you up on the ground and for having a good O-line, but as you mentioned, not a good O-line this year, just like last year. What can you say as far as what it speaks to as far as the inconsistency in the program this year?
Well, let me start with two things. First of all, nobody's having tremendous success in the SEC, and especially the SEC West right now, because there's a specter of Alabama and Nick Saban. And so the pressure is that everybody wants to have that kind of success while nobody is having that kind of success. When you add in what Bret Bielema likes to do, which is kind of the play smash-mouth traditional football, I think that plays into the kinds of things that Alabama does itself or likes to do itself and likes to stop, is good at stopping, and is doing it with better athletes. So Arkansas is trying to run similar schemes to what Alabama would like to run and is good at stopping, and what LSU has liked in the past to run and is good at stopping, but they've been doing it with lesser athletes. I actually think that probably, a move to a more wide-open attack that kind of helps equalize things is not a bad idea. And so for that reason, maybe Bret Bielema hasn't been as good a fit as he could have been otherwise.
George, thanks much. George Schroeder, USA Today. Appreciate the time.
Thank you, guys.